Cafe Enoma and wish you a very happy new year. We are going to react to The Doors and we are going to listen to the song Light My Fire.
Yeah, wish you peace, love, joy, prosperity, a lot of abundance of beauty, wonder and prosperity, money. Wish you all that in 2021, if that's what you desire, so it shall be, like WW84. And thank you for your love and support in helping us be true to ourselves. This is our channel, this is our reactions, these are our reaction videos. So thank you for your love and support in helping us being unscripted, pure, raw, honest, sincere, open and very, very straightforward in every single reaction video. We are not that common on YouTube, people like us, the way we do things. And thank you for your love and support. Thousands and thousands of you have stood by us, watched our reactions almost on a daily basis. We couldn't have asked for anything more. I hope we can continue to bring you honest reviews, a little bit of entertainment at times, a little bit of vocal aggression, so to say, at times from me especially. But that's who we are. That's who we are. We love something. I sing and dance if I love it. And if I don't like something, I'm very vocal about it. That's quintessential me, quintessential Kirti and quintessential Enoma. So thank you, thank you, thank you. The Doors, Light My Fire. In all honesty, I've heard this song maybe a dozen or more times before.
Wow.
So it's definitely not my first time listen and first time, but a first time response, obviously, or review to you. But let's see what Kirti thinks, because she's not heard it before today.
No.
I don't even have all these songs in my catalog anymore. It's been ages, maybe 15 years or so since all these songs were taken away from our collection by a sibling or a relative, because it was theirs to begin with. So they took it when they went abroad or they moved home. So I've not heard these in ages, and Kirti has never heard them in her life. So you can see a first time pure, raw, impromptu reaction. Let's get started. The Doors, Light My Fire.
That it would be untrue. You know that I would be a liar if I was to say to you, girl, we couldn't get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. The time to hesitate is through. No time to wallow in the mire. Try now, we can only lose. And our love become a funeral pyre. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. We'll be right back. The time to hesitate is through. No time to wallow in the mire. Try now, we can only lose. And our love become a funeral pyre. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire.
Wow, the Doors were on fire, literally on fire.
So spiritual. So much harmony, so much vitality, so much rhythm, so much rhyme.
So much rhythm.
The lines too.
Yeah. The music had spirit in it, isn't it? The keyboard, the drums, the vocals, everything, they were into it. They literally were in the music, or the music was flowing in them, either way.
Yeah, this was, there was so much of the guitar, there was so much of the organ that the Doors player uses.
I think the organ stole the show for me.
Usually it's the writing, it's the songwriting of Jim Morrison, the American poet as he's labeled. Mm-hmm. Usually it's the songwriting, usually it's his vocals that, you know, is the star of the show. Mm-hmm. But here it was so beautifully balanced, him starting, him ending. But then the organ throughout, the drums, the guitarist, oh, this was a complete rock song. This has got to be one of the best rock songs that has been created.
Yeah.
Wow. Wouldn't you say so
won't
as
be,
a first time listener?
Won't be an overstatement.
Someone who's not heard much music from the West, of course, before we started reacting to music that was requested.
Mm-hmm.
What are your thoughts on that? Do you think it's a high level song, it's a top notch song, one of the best?
Certain songs you definitely cannot connect beyond point, and certain songs you are so much into it that you have to really pull yourself out of it when it gets over. And it was one of those songs. You are completely into it. You are on a journey, musical journey with the musicians. You don't care about what is happening, how it is done, what exactly is their intention, what they are doing. But it's like that hypnotizing music experience that this presented. It's same like the snake, the way the snake starts moving when the snake charmer is playing his instrument.
But it's also the movement of that, basically, because the snake
is the movement of that. It can't hear.
Most venomous snakes can't really hear.
Yeah.
So it's basically the movement that they follow.
The snake charmer does.
They follow those movements. And this is like that, you know. I mean, this is music for the ages, for the masses, call it what you will. But obviously, the Indian in me, obviously, I like only Indian stuff. So how can I actually like this? How can I say I like this song? The Doors, Light My Fire, even though I loved it, how can I say it? That would make me...
Isn't that odd?
That would make me such a deshdrohi, as they call it, you know, anti-Indian. How can I say that I'm... And I say something like that, that I like this song when, you know, I'm an Indian. So, yeah, that's what people keep telling me on this channel, that, you know, I mean, if you don't like something, you're anti-American, anti-whatever, wherever the song is from or the artist is from. So you're anti-American, since I know he's an American musician or was, and the Doors were.
Yeah.
So you're an anti-American if you don't like this song.
Mm-hmm.
But in this case, you don't have to worry. Don't fret. Don't enter a state of anxiety and panic. Don't have a panic attack. Mm-hmm. I love it. Despite I'm being quintessentially an hardcore Indian, I love this song of the Doors, Light My Fire. And so does Kirti, apparently.
Yeah, I do. countries such as India or even America, America in the Western way, India in the Eastern way, we both are unique in the way we are. There are countries in the same world and not that far away where certain pictures cannot be even kept at home because the state does not want you to. You cannot eat more than the state does not want you to. You cannot watch something because the state does not want you to. We don't live in a country like that. We live in a very free country, very open country, very liberal country. We decide what we want to. And that is the freedom that our country gives us at all times, day and night at all times. We can do this living in our living room and nobody has a problem. Our family members, supporters, our friends, supporters, everybody likes what we do.
And I'll also add about the lyrics before we wind up.
Yeah.
That it's like an aphrodisiac. The way it's constructed,
yeah, something like that, yeah.
The lyrics as well as the music, it's like an aphrodisiac. And the lyrics are basically talking about that itself.
Mm-hmm.
That come on baby, light my fire. Let our, you know, love culminate with something much greater, something much more loving, more hardcore. Come on baby, light my fire. And tonight is the special night. Light my fire tonight. Something like that. Very spiritual, very loving, very romantic. The Doors way. Quintessential The Doors. This had beautiful chemistry between the members of The Doors. Something I haven't heard in a long time in rock music that has been requested on our channel. So this is refreshing. More of this might be very rare, but I definitely would love more of it. Indian or American, I think anyone who listens to this song with an open mind and who loves music will definitely appreciate the quality, the brilliance of The Doors in this one.
Music has no boundaries, and there are those, they definitely need treatment. Sometimes people should actually follow that line that says, before writing your comment, follow the community guidelines. They should actually think about what they type.
Yeah, I mean, for just because I don't like a song or you don't like a song or we give a negative review, doesn't make us anti-whatever. Doesn't make us that. We just don't like that song. So if you don't, so are you telling me that if you are an American or if you are an Englishman, you like all songs that come out of your country? And even if one song you dislike or 20 songs out of 200, does that make you anti-English? How stupid and retarded is that comment? And it keeps coming. It's not that it's just once.
And people keep justifying it.
And people justify it, support it. Yeah. They come and reply to such comments, supporting it and laughing at us. Shame on all of you retards. All of you retards who support such behavior and such words and such lines. Shame on you. It's because of you that wars are fought throughout history. People like you who always discriminate, always create imbalance in society. You are the imbalanced one. You are the one who's scared. You are the one who's pathetically retarded and needs to mature, needs to grow up, sadly. So just because I don't like this song or just because I love this song doesn't make me anti-Indian. Because it's an American song or an American rock song doesn't make me anti-Indian.
But I think I've said it in the past.
And just because this is not you know, Churchill's England or Hitler's Germany or Mussolini's Italy or Abraham Lincoln's America. This is not that. A colonial America. This is not that. That's history. That's in the past. Please grow up. Don't stick to those ethics and principles of your forefathers. Grow up. We have embraced and appreciated cultures from around the world. Not just Kirti and me. I'm talking about our whole country.
I think we almost everyone.
And
yeah.
Most people in this part of the world.
More receptive.
And because we have embraced and appreciated it, we've also been dominated, tortured and ruled. Mm-hmm. And even robbed from. Because we were
but
so nice. We were so nice. But that's history now.
Yeah.
That's history. So thank you for your support and love in giving this reaction and discussing this song and different things about us. Because you keep us here. Thanks to people like you. Even the naysayers, you help us get more views, you help us get more comments, you help us rise in the search results on YouTube. So all that you do, it actually helps us grow. In a very retarded kind of way, because that's the only language you'll understand. So
they don't like that word because they get offended.
So that's why I'm repeating it three times.
I know, you are really teasing.
Yeah. So in a very retarded kind of way,
yeah.
Those things help us. Yeah. Whether it's online or off, once you've posted it,
yes.
It actually helps us grow.
It motivates us a lot.
It helps us grow. So that's why we don't stop comments. People have said stop the comments for a while and check it out. Focus on your reactions. No, this is us. This is my life. This is our channel, my channel, her channel. This is us. We are not going to change who we are. We like discussing everything under the sun.
That's a quick,
essential Indian for you. Whereas there in that part of the world, or most parts of the world, is only black and white. In India, it's always gray.
It's
very gray. It's very colorful. It's, and in fact, it's always gray in the skies too, most of the year in most parts of India. Mm-hmm. We are the only countries possibly which has a monsoon season. Do you know that, Kirti?
Oh.
We are the only democracies and only countries
with a dedicated
monsoon season.
Is that so? I didn't know that.
A country of our size and anyone in that belt, over 100 million people of 50 million,
right.
We are the only ones.
Oh.
We have a proper monsoon season. So we have a lot of grey in our lives.
Okay.
We appreciate all the different shades of grey, all the different colours, and we embrace them, and hence we love this song. It doesn't make me anti-Indian, please. Don't worry.
You become pro-American after
I'm still Indian. And it doesn't make me pro-American either. Anti-Indian, pro-American.
I don't think we like that polarization.
Please leave your retarded ways in your own retarded...
One more time.
In your own retarded basement, in your own retarded corner of the world where you're stuck alone, retarded person, retarded soul that you are, please leave it there. And shame on all those other people who are equally retarded and depressed so as to support those retards in what they do.
Yeah.
This is an open world. The world is wonderful, it's beautiful, it's lively, it has balance. Please don't destroy it. Destroy it with your cheapness, with your low life sentiments and values and words. Please don't destroy it. Please don't ruin it for us and for everyone here who loves the whole world, not just one tiny retarded corner of the country or population.